Let's do an eye of the day today using Pan That Palette. We may call this Pan That Eye Look. I'm not sure. If you guys didn't know, I am panning the Lorac Palette as well as the Becca times Chrissy Teagen Palette. And today, I paired these two up today to create the eye look that I have on. So let's get into it. For shadow base, I used the Wet n Wild Fergi Primer. I did top that over with the NYX Above and Beyond Concealer. This guy's a little bit too dry for me right now, so I did mix in a little bit of the Bare Skin Bare Minerals Serum Concealer. And the purpose of that is just to blank out this particular area here. I did not set it, and that's the way that I've been using it most, to maximize the color pigmentation of these shadows on my eyes, especially some of the medium tone matte shadows. I grabbed Deep Purple here, this guy. Put it in the inner and outer corner. I did leave the center space blank. I blended that out and connected it here at the top, and then blended that further out with Mauve here, right in this area. I do have to pack it on quite a bit heavy in order for that to show through very well, to create a gradient basically. Deep Purple, this guy here, I did bring it in my lower lash more on this end here. I didn't smoke it out as much as I usually like to smoke out my lower lash, but because the top is so heavy, I didn't want to bring it too far down. Then I grabbed a mixture of Nude and Cream here to put a highlight under the arch of my brow. This is where I brought in a pigment, and this is the way I think moving forward on some of the eye looks that I'm gonna get use out of some of my single shadows basically. It's just kind of playing with this a little bit more. So I grabbed this Jessie's Girl pigment. This guy is their eye dust, and it's called Sunset Boulevard, and it has that really pretty pinky peachy gold kind of shift, and put that in the center of the lid space there. It's not as reflective as I wanted it. I really wanted something super sparkly and multi-dimensional. It adds a really nice little halo look, but I wanted some glitter. And unfortunately, I don't have anything within reach, so I pulled this guy here, and these are not the best. This is the Revlon Photo Ready Eye Art, and I grabbed a little bit of this guy here. This is the cream shadow, and then this is a little glitter. And I added the smallest amount. You can barely see it. I'm very tempted to get the ones from Urban Decay because I want to do that more this year and play with little glitters a little bit more. But anyways, grab that guy there and put it in this area. The little eye dust from Jessie's Girl, I also put it in this part of my lower lash here. And this is where I brought in the Becca palette here. I grabbed this guy here because it kind of plays a little bit with the idea of this little pigment here. It's a little bit more peachy and then slightly pink. I put that in the inner corner here, dragged it into Deep Purple, and then lower in this area here. And it's such a beautiful, oh gosh, I love these. These are smothered all over my face basically. This guy right here smothered on this area as well. I think it's so pretty. And I feel like the peach and the purple play very well together. The Deep Purple has this very fine pink shimmer. When you blend it out, it's not as noticeable. When you do pack it on the lid, you can see it. So I wanted to play along with that a little bit more, which is why I brought this pigment in. For liner, I used the Burgundy Suede from Estee Lauder, which is a burgundy brown liner in my waterline. I did put on Page Boy eyelashes, and these are from Kiss. They're so beautiful. Let me share with you guys what's on my face because I'm loving my complexion today. It was looking super dull and dead this morning, and this is the second time I do my eye look because initially I had used Garnet where the Deep Purple is and put this pigment, and I was not feeling that eye look, and I'm not gonna wear an eye look that I don't like, so which is why I switched it out. But anyways, I used the Born This Way foundation here and my serum concealer, and I set my entire face, under eyes, everything, with the Hourglass, this little guy. This is their ambient lighting, and it has the dim light, incandescent light, and radiant light, these guys. And I just grabbed a large brush and just went on all of them and just set my entire face, which is all of the glow that you're seeing on my entire face, except for this area here. That is the highlight from the Becca palette, and I'm loving my complexion. For blush, I did pull in this little guy from Too Faced. I just added the smallest amount more in this area here. This is Your Love Is King, which is a little bit of a pinky mauve, I guess you can say, blush. For lips, I did pull in this guy from Milani. I wanted a pinky nude, so this is Nude Creme, I think. and put that on, and then top that over with the Lorac Entrepreneur lip gloss. The smallest amount, because my lips are so dry right now. I have flaking going on and it's not very cute. So this gives it more of a moisturized look to the lips. And that is everything. That is everything, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to let me know what you guys are pairing up or enjoying pairing up from your Pan That palette. But this is the eye look that I got out of it, and I love it. I do wish I had a little bit more bling in this area, but that's okay. I think it worked out very, very well. I really enjoy it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.